expression.
Community and cultural coverage.
Music and calendar.
New visions and voices.
Coming to you with an Asian Pacific Islander point of view.
It's time to get on board the Apex Express.
Yes, 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 yes. Hello, 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 world. This is Adriel Lewis.
And Ruby Veridiano Ching.
And we are here
hosting tonight.
Guest hostess. We're also here with Gina. This is Apex Express, a pretty buoyant show. First Thursday of each month. APIA hip hop in your face. So we're going to just start this off right now. This is Deep Foundation with Heard 'Em Say. Heard it.
Promise some more today. In the walk, men die and martyrs made. And another mother calls the Lord to pray. As his wife is a flag and charter remains. Another home in the hood where no father was made. Broken homes are created because we're all in the gangs. And the cycle keeps going, so who ought to be blamed? They claim it's hip hop, they praying this shit stops. Because the rappers in the game that was slain, so give props. Now you walking in the hood and get sprayed up to the cops. And they saying that you bang because you playing hip hop. Just walk in my shoes, let the lies flip flop. You want all the posters and stop. I promise, cause it seems to me that ain't nothing what it appears to be. And it's clear to me, but to everybody else it's a mystery.
Like a mystery.
And we need to see
that it's a vicious cycle that's our history. The truth is we live life indifferently.
The evil in your life is tried for reasons. Where the devil try to challenge what you believe in. So these heathens are lured by fake prophets to make profits and cash it with ways of deceiving. So from day into evening, around the way inside of this globe in both regions, many die for strange reasons. Even a younger age for the flag, though we pledge allegiance. So God bless the troops overseas who couldn't dodge them and were supposedly there to only oversee. There's a bigger picture to the one you see. Step back, then look closely to the colors and brushstrokes of life's tainted upholstery. With deep quotes, hope to reach out and touch folks, cause it seems to me that ain't nothing what it appears to be. And it's clear to me, but to everybody else it's a mystery.
Like a mystery.
And we need to see
that it's a vicious cycle, that's our history. The truth is we live life differently.
It's a problem when I see the hood and I'm one of the occupants. When police wanna ask for my documents, hesitate that they won't be breathing their oxygen. With poverty or sovereignty, wanna lock us in. But honestly, I never did nothing wrong to them. I could get charged for anything, even consonants, while everybody overlooking incompetence. Of a system with flaws, making victims in wars. Evidence of the struggles lie right outside of my door. When people die just because they'd rather hustle than starve. So just ride for the cause, there's a hustle involved. And of course, gotta send them abroad and enforce to enforce silly laws, but the cause is preposterous, yo. Just think about it, it's getting me anxious. It ain't nothing what it appears to be. And it's clear to me, but to everybody else it's a mystery.
Happy New Year, world. How are you feeling? Well, I guess you can't really answer through the radio.
Always going to be great, though.
Yes. How you feeling, Ruby?
I am feeling excellent. Well, a little tired because I've been working all day. But,
oh, really?
You know,
Other people have a harder, Ruby.
I know. Stop it. But, you know, oh, wait. Great in 08.
Yes, great in 08. How you feeling, Gina?
You know, you guys have really woken me up, man. These
wonderful.
So what's happening tonight?
Tonight we have a really great action-packed show. The song you just heard is by Deep Foundation, this really dope hip-hop crew out of Queens I got to meet earlier last year. So they're going to be on the phone with us in a little bit. We're also going to be interviewing Sakit Masouf, and he's going to be, you know, giving us a bit of a reaction about the assassination with Benazir Bhutto and kind of how that affects the community out here, not just in Pakistan. You know, it's something that's definitely affecting all of us, and so we're going to look into that. So, you know, that's all what right, it is. That's what's right. on the plate for today. So I guess we're just going to start off right now. You know, world, we're gonna meet Deep Foundation. And, you know, so before we get on the phone, I want to prepare you because, you know, these are some Filipino-Americans, but, you know, they have these thick Queens accents. And the first time I met them, I was tripping because, you know, I was like, I don't know what I expected, you know.
Yeah, I would be like, hello. People,
you can hear me talking already. Oh, man, I thought I was... Okay.
You know,
well,
Bay Area got their own accent too. You know?
How you feeling, Deep Foundation?
Hey, what is good? What is bad?
Yeah.
Who,
so
who do we got on the phone tonight?
We got Ill Poetic. And this is Mugshot.
Ill Poetic, Mugshot.
Two of many. You know, the rest of ain't here.
Yeah, I guess you could say that you have a pretty deep foundation.
Yes, indeed.
Right. So how are your holidays?
Oh, man, it was good. You know, incident-free for the most of us. You know, just family stuff. You know, a lot of cassava cake and good Filipino food, you know, for the kids.
Cassava cake or
cassava cake?
Cassava cake. Oh,
man.
Eating them Caesar in Queens.
My mother's the best cassava cake.
Yo, you can't sleep on Ill Poetic's mom's cassava cake. Yo, you got to get some.
Cassava cake. Cassava cake.
Cake and 08.
Cake and 08.
Cake and 08. Yo,
that's what's up this year.
It's for lifetimes, though. It's for eternity is the best, man. I got to represent my mom's cooking.
Okay, cool. So are you guys in at Jersey right now? Are you guys in Queens right now? Where am I calling you from?
Nah, this is Queens right here. It's Woodside.
Yeah, representing Queens. The Jersey guys are in Jersey.
Okay, where? So you wanna tell us a little bit about Deep Foundation? Kind of how it started and stuff like that?
Basically, it's a group of MCs and B-boy, DJ, and a bunch of other heads basically representing hip-hop from Queens, New York, and New Jersey. And, so it's a bunch of us. There's other members in the group. And I don't know if we have time to name all of them, but...
Name them.
All right,
we
got
no
Deep
Foundation.
It's CJ, or a Poetic Mugshot. There's CJ, there's Proceed, there's Verbal Tech, there's Words Arise, there's Sound G, there's Suitcase, there's Graph Hopper, there's TJ, who just had a kid, Mike Intellect, who just got engaged. The original DJ of Deep Foundation. Scribe, Therapist, Dennisy, Cello, and Adrian Prettyman.
Wow. It's the Pinoy Wu-Tang Clan.
I was about to say the exact same thing.
Yeah, yo, that's exactly it, man, with the Filipino Wu-Tang.
Wow. Cool. So the first time I saw you guys perform was out in Queens, and it was after the Asian American Spoken Word Summit, and you guys, you know, you shared the stage with Kiwi, you shared the stage with Blue Scholars, and, you know, these are some folks that, you know, within the hip-hop community, you know, are really, you know, well-renowned. You know, they've gone, you know, all throughout the country and everything, and you guys, you know, from what I saw, you guys just rocked it just as well. You know, you just blew everybody away, and it was really cool, man.
Thank you, man. We appreciate that.
Yeah, appreciate it a lot. Yeah, you know, we're really blessed to be on that card that night, actually. It was a real big deal for us to be actually splitting the shine with cats like that. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I'm glad that you noticed that we kind of killed it that day.
Because you know?
We kind of killed it.
No, but peace to everybody else that was on there. So I can't name everybody, but I know Koba, mm-hmm. who's repping Brooklyn, and Hanalei Ramos, I always mess up her last name, was there too. And it was a nice showcase of Filipino talent, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Both in the West Coast and in the East Coast. So, mm-hmm. I mean, we were just blessed to be a part of it. And of course, Illiteracy, you know, y'all didn't perform that day, but y'all repped hard in the summit, so.
Thank you, good sir, thank you. So, a lot of the people that we talk to on this show are from the Bay Area. And so, you know, and also a lot of the listeners are from the Bay Area. And in the Bay, you know, it's really diverse. You know, there's a bunch, you know, there's like, Asians everywhere. You can't, you know, you can't really walk somewhere without stepping on an Asian.
Right.
So, but when you get to New York, it's a different experience. And then also when you go into Queens, it's a different experience. So for those of us who you know, haven't really spent a lot of time in Queens, can you kind of, you know, give us a little rundown of what it's like to grow up Filipino in Queens?
Marcus, how you got this?
Yeah. Well, first of all, I'd like to just drop a little knowledge on everyone. You know, Queens is the most diverse locality within the entire world.
Yes.
So just within the borough itself, you know, you're gonna find a huge array of people. Like, I'm gonna tell you right now, I used to live in a place called Jackson Heights, and I would walk out of my house and I would hear 5 different languages on the way to the grocery store, which was about 3 blocks away. Mm-hmm. So, you know, that's just to set a little background. You know, growing up as a kid, you know, you're around all types of people. You know, I was going to school with, like, Greek kids, Italian kids, Dominican kids, Puerto Rican kids, Indian kids, Chinese kids, you know. Mm-hmm. And for a large part of the time, I was one of the only Filipino people. Mm-hmm. So, you know, it's kind of different. I would say it's probably different from growing up in the Bay. But at the same time, you know, everywhere you go, it's just people, you know. It's, mm-hmm. it's all it is.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, it's definitely diverse. And, you know, like I was... It's really where I grew up in the side of Queens, like in Astoria, Long Island City. There weren't a lot of Filipinos, but they, you know, you had other, you know, like an array of other races, you know, races or whatever ethnicities, and it kind of just made itself where your race was not an issue, your ethnicity was not an issue. It was just like, you know, I mean, people were just getting along and, you know, just learning about other cultures and whatnot. So it was a great experience in my opinion growing up in Queens, because I feel like I learned a lot more about, you know, different religions and different, you know, cultures with, based on, like, the different friends that I've had.
So. Word.
Plus, you can't even go to that Manila corner in Queens, right?
Yeah, there's a little strip, man. We got, like, 2 blocks.
I saw that. It's like Manila Town. It's like 5 stores, but they represent hard, though.
Yeah, it's a weird, you know, in the span of 2 blocks or whatever it is, block and a half, you have a good amount of dope Filipino restaurants and stores and the Johnny Air Cargo people to mail your stuff out. Mm-hmm. You're set.
Yeah, man, I gotta say, you know, because all along, you know, I've always had New York in my mind, and every, you know, ever since I had that in my mind, I always thought about doing Brooklyn. But last time I was in New York, I have to say, man, Queens really kind of stole my heart. So.
Oh man, that's
up.
We're biased, but I mean, I love Brooklyn too, man. Brooklyn is like the second best borough in my opinion, because it's just a lot of love, and there's a lot of history in Brooklyn too.
Brooklyn's cool.
Queens.
Word. Well, so we're gonna go ahead and play another song, and then we're gonna come back, and I wanna talk to you a bit about, you know, your influences and how you got into hip hop and all that stuff. So keep that in mind. But the next song we're gonna play is also by you guys. It's called Stumble. So check it out.
Gully stuff. This is the gully stuff.
This is the gully stuff. Word. Develop a vengeance. Your effort to be relentless is no match for my method and verses. Fall back and we can set a test, and you don't wanna rumble. Young man, rumble with serious business. I'll be your delirious stitches. And for all of you curious stitches, so just know that we leave you with numerous stitches. Yeah, forget it, it's fandom. Assemble an anthem. Dismantle your factions and murder you has been without the burn of the magnum. So you see, it ain't simple, B. Still, something like Pistol Pete, I'll slay these punks more than once.
They said we'll never make it. Laughter, the dreams we chasing. Patiently waiting for a stumble. Just one stumble. For us to fail, they praying. These suckers know they hating. Hoping all night and day we stumble. Just one stumble.
Check it out, man. Press him a button. It's a gut to cut in the mouth. Ain't that something? I'm throwing it down with no gibberish now. Flipping any gap beats, so we study. For the street is here. Most cats will be like, oh yeah, we've been through jail. Conscience still seems. Seems like you ain't cast unless you throw the pill. That's just my life and dramas. Everything that I do is a promise. Don't wanna patronize you, but I'm not trying to do full plastic. Yes, so honest. I'm a voice disaster. This man that was enough. I finished and start the jam. So fabulous, bitch, ridiculous. Get the lyrics, what happened here? You can tell from the weight that he shouldered. Feeling like his life was over. Had him clinging so close to the heat when approaching these streets. Gotta know that the night gets colder. Plus all the things he's seen. From Queens to the Philippines, scenes getting bigger jeans. Pumping bass on the block, what's the yay of the rock? When they dream about the queen, it's quick as means. But it's true. No pops, it's a cool. No girls, it's lost. City mad at the show. Be a thug, get in the hustle, got drugs, write the bundles in the kid. Made sure, didn't let him know. Had to build that breath. To pick up for them, step. That's a rumble that he beat to the death. Didn't matter pretty soon with his breath. Had a wound in his chest, he was doing.
booze and the cigarettes. Now there ain't no one else to go. When his health was low, felt like some other person. It cursed him. This was his life, just a first version. Young man got dealt a blow, so he made a peace sign, but he held it low. Wish he could be signed, but he tell him no. He knows he can speak rhymes and get it to flow. That's much better than his one. He down, that's when he's low. So
they said we'll never make it. Laughter to the dreams we chasing. Patiently waiting for a stumble. Just one stumble. For us to fail, they praying. These suckers know they hating. Hoping all night and day we stumble. Just one stumble.
Word up. Word up, word up. That was Deep Foundation with Stumble, and we have Deep Foundation on the phone. How you feeling, fellas?
Feeling all Bay Area.
Word. So you kind of just killed it on that track too.
That was Mugshot at the end of that. Yeah, you did kill it, right?
Yeah.
Hold up, I gotta do this. We're in the Bay Area right now, right?
Uh huh.
Yay! Oh God, I can't believe I did that.
Man. You know you study it on YouTube. Don't even. Fight.
Yo, it's horrible. It's horrible. Man. You gotta see me turf dancing. Right. You gotta see Mugshot turf dancing.
Study of Bay Area culture on YouTube.
Hey, yeah, we're trying to diversify. That's all.
See, just a couple of months ago, Deep Foundation, listeners, Deep Foundation actually came out to Berkeley, and they performed with us at UC Berkeley, and it was like in a small classroom, but they're like dealing with like the instrumental coming out of headphone speakers and stuff, but they still killed it, and so that's how you know a crew is versatile is when they can rock a classroom.
Man, peace to Maganda Magazine too, yes, man. They showed us so much love out there, and Adriel for hooking us up, man. We got to rock in front of a Bay Area crowd, so that's always a big thing.
Of course. So dealing with Queens again and hip hop. I mean, at Queens, you have LL Cool J, you have Nas, But I kind of want to know how you guys got into hip hop, especially growing up as Filipino Americans.
Well, you want to talk on it? I mean, I like Howard Isley growing up. That joke we got. Not for the most part. I listened to a lot of like Mobb Deep and Nas like growing up because I'm from Queens. But like, to tell you the truth, the first person that really got me into hip hop like hard was DMX.
Hard.
Mm. Yeah, it was DMX. It's dark and hell is hot.
Uh-huh.
So I was on a whole different like kind of level with rap when I was starting rapping. I was talking about like my dogs and stuff like that.
That was my dog bar. It sounded like a gorilla though. Sorry.
I mean, a big influence I think in the group has to be like cats like Biggie, obviously from New York. Biggie, Jay-Z is like probably the group. If I had to say the group's favorite MC,
uh-huh.
Obviously Pac, you got Nas, and just like just music in general. But I would have to say Black Star was a big influence too.
There you go.
When they came out, I think a lot of us, if she was in the group, when they first came out as a group, it was just like, the Definition came out, we just heard it, and a lot of us just kind of reacted the same way, like, oh, like, this is some real hip-hop-ish right here, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
And it inspired you to want to write, to hear those cats, so.
Mm-hmm. Nah, yeah, definitely feel you, man. I just found my, like, this old 9-10-year-old Source magazine with Jay-Z on the cover. It was like right after Volume 2 came out, and Black Star was on the mic check, like,
oh, where
the
they?
Featured That's new nice. Artist, and it was like this rapper named Mos Def, who you might recognize from the Deion Sanders MasterCard commercials. So it's like a lot has changed in the last 10 years, man. So I mean, so how long have you guys been around?
Man, it seems like 2001 roughly. Wow. We've been around for a while. Just it took us a while to kind of really take it seriously, because at first it was just a matter of us being friends, and we were a bunch of friends who happened to be MCs, and they're like, why not get together and why not do shows around here and get whatever shows, But eventually I think we saw like that people were actually really feeling us, and we kind of started taking it more seriously. I would say starting around like 2003, that's when we were really like, kind of like getting into it and really recording and putting out our first bootleg CD with like the crappiest Word document cover ever. So I would say, 2001, though, was the inception of the group.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So you mentioned you have influences by, like, you said your favorite group is your group's favorite MC is Jay-Z. I'll say in the literacy, it's the same thing too. We're always like, when you said Jay-Z, me and Ruby just both threw up the rock sign.
Said hope under our breath.
Hope. But so what I want to ask you actually, because you grew up not really being as exposed to, like, you know, to, like, Native Guns and Blue Scholars and stuff like that.
Right.
And so, and you know, that really shows through in your style, because it's very independent of the style. Like you can tell that it was very shaped by growing up in Queens.
Right.
You know, and so, well, I want to ask...
And Jersey,
you know. So what I want to ask you is as Filipino-Americans, do you feel like there's a specific kind of style that you feel, you know, separates you, you know, from other rappers and artists specifically because of your race or ethnicity?
I think, well, our approach is basically, like, we're not trying to be quote-unquote Filipino about it. You know, it's just that we're hip-hop heads first. Like, our music really, like you pointed out, is based on the music that we listen to, and you know, so, like, of course, being Filipino, we're gonna talk about Filipino issues. So, you know, but in terms of style, though, it's really just, you know, we kind of try to convey the kind of music that we would listen to, and I, you know, generally speaking, it'll be East Coast influenced music, you know.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, you guys are just across the way from, you know, just a subway away from Bronx, where hip hop, you know, was born.
Oh, Mugshot knows all about the Bronx.
Really? Tell me about that.
I used to go to high school in the Bronx.
So, oh, word.
Yeah, it's a rough spot to travel to, I'll tell you that much.
So I guess in that case, then, like, how does that whole issue fit in? Especially, you know, a lot of people talk about, you know, hip hop being specifically for one community of people, one group of people, like, and being so close to the birthplace of hip hop. How has that affected your experience?
I think people look at us more skeptically as far as, like, hip hop, because we're not the quintessential hip hop group, regardless of how diverse we say that Queens is or that New York is in general. Like, people still do have a certain idea of what a hip hop group should be, and, you know, that's just the industry's effect on everything. But, you know, I think we've been tested on some of, like, the firmest grounds in terms of critics are concerned, and, you know, we're just out here just trying to be us. And I think that it's made us better for that.
So, like, what have the crowds been like at the shows you've gone? Because you know, like, even you guys have been to Cali, you've been to Virginia, like, y'all are really representing.
I mean, wait, what was the question?
Like, what kind of crowds have you guys been receiving? What's been the response? Right, I guess is it different, you know, in Queens than it is in Virginia?
What kind of show we're doing? You know, it could be if it's like a, you know, obviously if it's like a Filipino society, obviously we have a lot of Filipinos.
Yes,
but
yes,
of course, no, we've done open mics. We've done, like, you know, different shows where it's, like, just a diverse crowd, like, in the clubs or whatever. Asian, like, just general Asian. We've actually done, like, Chinese, what is it? What is that thing in Rutgers? We've done, like, Chinese organizations they have over there.
I don't know.
It was, like, a talent show back in. That's when we started, and we were just, like, all screaming at the mic with, like, no idea of, like, stage presence. You know, but we did, I mean, we've done all types of shows, you know, just, because it's really, to us, we just want to rock in front of a crowd. I don't care if it's a group of people from, you know what I mean, from Alaska. It doesn't matter. You know what I mean? Like, it's just, we're on stage, and we're conveying whatever, you know, message we want to convey and share our music, and, you know, it doesn't really matter what crowd it is.
Word. Cool. Well, so we're gonna roll out with one more song, and then you know, and then peace out. So I was wondering if you guys could just kind of drop information on people when they listen to your music, where else they can find you.
You can check us out on myspace.com/deepfoundation. That's DeepFoundation. Spelling bee champion.
Killer, yeah.
Yes, it's foundation, not foundation, okay? Listeners, spell it the right way.
Word, some people they think it's D, like the letter D, and then foundation. It's deep, as in not shallow.
Like poetry.
Yeah. Okay, that was right. Corny.
Yes, sir.
So the last track we're playing tonight is Diamond the Rough. You want to kind of tell us about that?
Actually, it's crazy. The way I got inspired to actually write my verse to the song is I saw this pregnant teenage girl on the train one day, and she was asking everyone for money. So that's kind of like, it's a song about single mothers and the struggle that they go through, and basically just trying to persevere over that, and, you know, just...
And it's also just to focus on, like, the bond between, you know, mother and child, and not think about, like, you know, the society looking down on, like, single mothers or young single mothers. We lose sight of the fact that it's about, you know, we should focus on the love that they share and the bond that they share more than anything else.
Word. All right, well, this is one of my favorite tracks from you guys, so this is Deep Foundation,
thanks,
Diamond in the Rough.
All right, get them.
Word.
Oh, man, I should do that.
Somebody told me that God works in strangest ways. And I try to do my best, but my strength keeps fading away. And I really don't know what it is that tomorrow will bring. So I try to hold on just to get through the sorrow and pain.
Single mother working hard for the kids, hoping that she put they starve in the end. And she knows she's still far from the end, but the stress makes it hard to pretend. Yo, this wasn't part of the plan. She loved the heart of a man that disappeared after she gave him a hand. After he made her some kids, he displayed her and did. Plus it got worse, the bank's repossessing the crib. Now he's back with her mom again, back on the same block her pops got shot up in. Neighbors always hollering, raising up her kids that never had any fathering. Shorty's still a rose, but she just not blossoming. It's just not possible, projects he's living in. 19 and ignorant, tight jeans and Timberlands. Girlfriends gossiping, the money's not depositing. Shorty go to school, but she wonders why she bothering.
Somebody told me that God works in the strangest ways. And I try to do my best, but my strength keeps fading away. And I really don't know what it is that tomorrow will bring. So I try to hold on just to get through the sorrow and pain.
Yo, she's counting up the money she's collected a year, and they're literally stained by her sweat and her tears. Both fear as long as debts disappear, and her kids stay fed as she can get them some gear. Reputation is smeared because of a crushing career, disregarding all the efforts and her methods they sneer. But she's here and she's trying to clear the hurdle and go. See her man turn into shit when it's her and her soul. How a fan burner bridges took the worst of the toll. She won't wave the white flag though she working the pole. It is such a heavy burden for one person to hold. When she sees her kids smile, it is worth it, she knows. As far as personal goals, she wants to have a degree. The bumps in the road, she just has to proceed with the drive that she gets from her love for her seeds. And they love her right back, that's all the loving she needs.
Somebody told me God works in strangest ways. And I try to do my best, but my strength keeps fading away. Cause I really don't know what it is that tomorrow will bring. So I try to hold on just to get through the sorrow and pain.
She looked into her baby's eyes right before she waved goodbye. Saw the reason that she knew she had to stay alive. It almost made her cry, trying to hold the tears back. Regretting the regrets felt a couple years back. Her fears were made clear, she was scared and felt worthless. But as her belly grew, she knew there was a purpose. Cause there was a child staring wide-eyed and perfect. The love and ask God, do I really deserve it? Had a seed you was young, your latitudes are now gone. Now you're seeing your reflection as you're greeting your mom. Keep on reading the Psalms and seeking peace in Qurans. Or whatever you believe in, keep believing in God. And I leave it to y'all, men are treating me wrong. So leave them, you don't need them, tell them beat it so long. I hope we reach some of y'all, we won't be speaking the song. May I brought you back to earth, but still reach for the stars.
Somebody told me that God works in strangest ways. And I try to do my best, but my strength keeps fading away. I really don't know what it is that tomorrow will bring. So I try to hold on just to get through the sorrow and pain. Getting through the sorrow and pain,
everybody. So those of you just joining us, that was Deep Foundation out of Queens, this hip-hop crew that we just interviewed. Before we sign off with them, they wanted us to also let you know that there's a brand new music video on the YouTube. So just go on YouTube.com in the search thing, just type in Deep Foundation, spell it out, it's two words. Check out the music video, go to MySpace.com/deepfoundation. So We're going to be on the phone with Saqib Masoof soon, but I want to bring it back to the West Coast first. So this is another dope artist. His name is Fitz Av. He's out of Sacramento. This is from the mixtape called City of Trees. The song's called Imagine. And for those of you who have been, you know, in this Asian American scene for a while, you might recognize the person in the second verse. His name's Quest out of the world-renowned spoken word crew, Eighth Wonder. He's doing the MC thing now. So yes, this is Imagine by Fitz Av and Quest.
Get over, you can look forward to more funerals, more and more dead-end jobs and more cubicles. I just swallow my pain like it was chewable and drop lines wherever they feel suitable. I guess I get in where I fit in without casting kids who feel indifferent, cause of simply living. Cause simple living isn't that simple, is it? When world leaders lying, flicker they tongue like lizards. They snakes, shakes, Illuminati's and pimps pocketing billions while I'm barely paying my rent. I'm asking for change. These crackers talking in sense. They building ghettos without the lock on the fence. I try to think outside of that box, but I'm right back at home when I get harassed by the cops. And my brother stay in trouble trying to peddle that rock. Now we got two felons, a silver line in this dark. I'm 22 with 3 ticks on the clock and a chance for the stars. I just need to get off a shot. Haters violate my formulation of plot. Even my own father doesn't think that it's hot. Imagine that. I feel like no one's got my back. It's so small pond being big fish in sack. But I'ma keep spitting till we get on the map. The strange kid made it and I ain't looking back like that. Can you imagine how the future's really gonna be? Can it be worse than anything we already see? And see, the reason I ask the question so tough is cause it's something we don't even think about enough. But on the other hand, here I am sitting back watching the world. Two cautious eyes, afraid to see time unfurl. Cause when I spot trouble in a child so young, the darker my prediction of the future seems to become. And it's hard for me to warn them when they think nothing's wrong, cause they've been imprisoned by the same system too long. Efficiently conditioned to simply follow along, cause they believe what they see is where they're meant to belong. But who the hell am I to try to teach them better ways to live when I never even once stood in the place of these kids? I never been shot or chased for racist pigs, and they supposed to be inspired by the wisdom I give. So it's obvious the irony just can't be ignored. I'm middle class while these kids are underprivileged and poor, and I acknowledge that we live in the presence of war. So the same kind of pain's bleeding on distant shores. Still, my pen moves in motivated ways, guided by the mere chance that I could generate some change. Cause thoughts of doomed futures could simply be erased if I imagine something beautiful to put in its place. Imagine.
Whoa, that was a bit fast. Bit fast there. This is G, and you're listening to KPFA. I am the senior member on this hip-hop night of Asian Pacific Islander hip-hop music. You've been listening to Adriel, again, KPFA in Berkeley, KPFE in Berkeley, KFCF in Fresno, and online at www.kpfa.org. This is Apex Express. My co-host tonight is Ruby. She is a performance artist, spoken word in particular. Is that right, Ruby? Maybe
yes,
you can just
yes,
say a little
yes.
bit more.
Yeah, I'm actually in the same crew as Adriel Lewis here. Illiteracy, so we're representing right now here on the airwaves.
You know, we're going to be getting into something that's kind of a global situation. There is a much larger South Asian community coming up. Pakistani and Pakistanis Americans have been hit pretty hard by 9/11 and by all the stuff that's going on in the South Asian diaspora. I think a lot of the community, especially in the Pakistani community, have been sort of targeted under Bush's so-called war on terror. But there's so many people that have been really affected by it. Tonight we are going to talk with a friend of ours, Saqib Masoof. He is a member of Third Eye, which is the organization that puts on the wonderful Third Eyes Film Festival called the South Asian Film Festival. And he is really interested and very busy in the arts sector in the South Asian community. He has also done a video. He has gone to Pakistan. He is from Pakistan originally. He has gone to Pakistan where the earthquake happened a couple of years ago. So he's very involved in what's going on. Tonight we're going to ask him, though, a little bit more about what the Pakistani-American community faces in light of what's going on in the South Asian community, in light of this recent tragedy of following military leadership, following the U.S.'s very, very deep interference and, I mean, interest in the country. So, Saqib, hello, how are you?
Good evening, Dina.
Thank you so much for joining us. I just want to kind of start off, given that, you know, there's been so much attention on what's going on. Benazir Bhutto was just assassinated. Now it looks like she's got her youngest son, 19-year-old son, who might be coming to the fore. His father actually will be governing the organization, the Pakistan People's Party, if and when the elections happen. But there's also like there's two younger players in this Pakistani situation in terms of her 19-year-old son. I mean, if you can imagine a 19-year-old son, he's as old as Adriel here, our co-host, just walking into a situation like that. There's also another 25-year-old woman that you were talking about that is also very progressive, also a possible contender. So maybe you can talk about these two young people and what they're going to bring to the politics of this country right now.
Yeah, it's obviously we are all reeling from the tragic events, but you know, it's the unfortunate situation of South Asian politics that we have dynasties, and as you well know, we have the Gandhi dynasty, and from there on we have the Pul dynasty in Pakistan. And Benazir's son, Bilawal Zardari, who just got the new name Bilawal Bhutto Zardari, you know, he's 19 years old. We know very little about him. He is part of the generation that is growing up outside of Pakistan. And, you know, a lot, I don't doubt that as a 19-year-old, he could bring a lot of energy into the situation, but we know very little about him at this point. And he seems like a very unfortunate selection within the party, which I think it was not democratically done. A better option to me has always been Benazir's niece, who's, I think, 25 at this point, Fatima Bhutto. And she is the daughter of, you know, the eldest son of Zulfikar Ali Bhutto, who was killed during Prime Minister Benazir Bhutto's second term in power. And the niece, Fatima Bhutto, has written about the earthquake in Pakistan. She regularly writes on Counterpunch. She has a very, you know, she has an agenda that has, you know, it's a reminder to us of how Benazir used to be in the 70s, where we could, as Pakistanis, put a lot of hopes on someone who can bring social justice and modernity to this nation.
Now, when you say, you know, modernity to the nation, and when you say Pakistan is, you know, in trouble, but my question is, in the United States, the only thing that we seem to hear about is, well, you know, how's Pakistan and the war on terror going to figure in the next election, and that's about all you hear. But what has been the role of, you know, the colonial impact in Pakistan and what we see today? I know that's a huge history, but if you can, you know, try and be real specific about that, I think it'll give people a little bit of background about what's going on in the country and why people sort of react kind of negatively to the United States.
Well, you know, I mean, the way I read it, and this is my viewpoint, is Pakistan, somewhat like Turkey, was always Sipahi, which is like a soldier state. It has been the breeding ground of recruitment of soldiers from the British colonial times. A lot of the army was recruited from the Punjab and frontier province. The whole theory of the martial races came from, you know, recruitment in the Punjab and NWSP province. Now, what happened, obviously, is those, because of the fact that Pakistan was very heavily military, had military recruitment, Pakistan had always been seen as a soldier state. And the American, who were the successors of the British colonial Raj, in a way, wanted to keep Pakistan as a military state. So we've always seen that being played out. You know, we've seen Benazir, the late Benazir, say a lot of things about how the military had created the monster of the fundamentalist parties. But it was during an own second term in government that General Nasrullah Babur, who by some is said to be the founder of the Taliban, he was supporting them. That was done during our own term. So it's a mess in a way that, you know, in America, we keep propping up the military, and the military keeps propping up these covert organizations that have come back to bite Pakistan and America. And, you know, it's like, we've been raising this snake within us. And this is the snake that got Benazir herself. I have no doubts in my mind, I have no doubts that it was the extremists who were openly mocking her and saying that, you know, I've got 50 suicide bombers ready to kill you. So it's really sad that, you know, we see this circle coming back and enveloping the nation in, you know, in this grief and in this really sad spectacle that we see right now. With the worst thing about this whole thing is not just her death, but the hundreds of people that have died. There have been, like, hospitals for mentally handicapped engines that have been destroyed by People's Party activists, ambulances burned, and it's just chaos. It's really sad that we have come to this point.
Now, Saqib, like, because I know that this is a tragedy that affects Pakistanis and also a lot of Pakistani Americans. How do you think that, in the light of the political climate in America post 9/11, how do you think that this tragedy or this situation will affect the communities here in America?
Well, I mean, I think, you know, we are sort of reeling from it, but the community here that I know, they do know one thing, which is, we were very, very agitated by the emergency. The people I belong to, the Friends of South Asia and, you know, some other political parties there, wanted to establish rule of law. We wanted the judge to be reinstated, the Supreme Court judge. But all that is lost. Now we have a dynasty that's saying that a 19-year-old son is going to be the leader of the biggest party. Mm. And Mr. 10%, who's a very corrupt person, for most Pakistanis, is the de facto head, co-chairman.
That's so Benazir's husband, who's...
Yeah, yeah. Mr. Zatari. So the whole rule of law and restatement of the Chaudhary, Iftikhar Chaudhary, the Supreme Court, that all has been lost now. And it's really unfortunate, and we really have to work hard to keep focused on the most important thing, which is rule of law with party and within the nation. Mm-hmm.
The other question before we have to kind of wind this up, I know you're trying to take care of your father and everything, but what are some of the sides or some of the activities that might be happening as really events unfold in the area of Pakistan and in the diaspora? Do you have any contact numbers or any information?
Well, I mean, the most important side that we have a lot of news. And news groups within the community that we communicate through, and Friends of South Asia, which is Friends of South Asia, ORG, the organization that I represent, is very heavily committed to support for the judiciary, support for rule of law. That is the most important thing, and I think any South Asian who believes in the democratic process should keep that in mind as the most important thing of all. So friendsofsouthasia.org is the organization I think we can, and we have a new group, and we have a lot of members, and I think primarily we are concerned with getting the democratic process back on track in Pakistan and not be led into some kind of a hysteria about how Al-Qaeda take over the nuclear weapons in Pakistan, which is quite frankly quite wrong. It's not going to happen. The military even that. I mean, that's not the main concern. And because of this hysteria, you know, we keep supporting the military, and the military can do whatever they want. So I think it's kind of a catch-22, but the reality is that we have to believe in democracy and trust that even democratic leaders in Pakistan will be doing the same thing that the military will do as far as the nuclear weapons. are concerned or fighting the, you know, extremists are concerned.
Okay, so keep, we don't want to keep you anymore because you're breaking up a little bit on the phone, but I want to say thank you once again for being on Apex Express. Just give out that site one more time, the South Asia site one more time.
Yeah, it's Friends of South Asia, so FRIENDSOF South Asia .org.
Okay, we want to say thank you so much for taking your time out, and I'm sure that events are still unfolding in that country. So thanks again for being on Apex Express, and we are going to go turning this over to Adriel to bring us into our next song that's coming up.
Thank you very much.
Very much to keep. So the next song we're going to be playing is by Blue Scholars. It's actually off this this EP that they just came out with towards the end of last year. The song's called Southbound. It's, I think it's actually very relevant to what we've been talking about. So peep it.
No matter where you are, the struggle's nearby, and it ain't enough time for lovers to say hi. Some nights require a spark, a fire to remind us what we really look like in the dark. So let it go,
let it go,
and let it go,
let it go,
and let it go,
let it go.
Just let it go,
let it go,
let it go,
let it go,
and let it go,
let it go,
let it go,
let it go.
Just let it go,
let it go.
Yeah. Miss Mahogany, I hear you calling me.
Hello.
You had a dream last night that you were rocking me, and now you're talking to fulfill the prophecy. I got you open like a true democracy. My policy has always been ladies first. It begins where the skin starts and ends where it hurts. You the first one to find me in the cold like that. No disguise when the prize make your eyes roll back, I suppose. Makes us want to fight that harder, I know. Sometimes the fire need water, so call up your partners and tell them not to bother, cause tonight we getting far from the cops and the robbers. Do it like moms and pops when they made us, simulating scenes by adult entertainers, burning two meals worth of calories. Later we just lay there and laugh, it pays to relax. No matter where you are, the struggle's nearby, and it ain't enough time for lovers to say hi. Some nights require a spark, a fire to remind us what we really look like in the dark. So let it go,
let it go,
and let it go,
let it go,
and let it go,
let it go,
just let it go,
let it go,
let it go,
let it go,
and let it go,
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 yeah. I see how you work. Lately you've been grim and determined to win. It's how they want us to get. Now we come to expect nothing less than the best. Just pause and reflect. Nothing honest is sweat. Now we linger in the heat, simmer in the sheets. Put the tingle in your feet. Voodoo on repeat. How does it feel to make your cipher complete? Daily you professional. At night she's a freak. Now she's just chilling, I'm just chilling. Let's inspire the neighbors to make children. But all the travel is making the love limited. Feeling like a prisoner with conjugal visiting. Every time I break you off, feeling religious, saying, oh my God, oh my God. Conversations till one, have relations till four. In the morning you've been warned, I'm a warrior, y'all. No matter where you are, the struggle's nearby, and it ain't enough time for lovers to say hi. Some nights require a spark, a fire to remind us what we really look like in the dark. So let it go,
let it go,
and let it go,
let it go,
and let it go,
let it go,
just let it go,
let it go,
let it go,
let it go,
and let it go,
let it go,
let it go,
let it go,
just let it go,
let it go.
Okay.
Yes, so that was Blue Scholars once again off the newly released Joe Metro EP. If you like that, check out Blue Scholars at bluescholars.com or myspace.com/bluescholars. You are here at Apex Express Hip Hop Week, the Pretty Buoyant Show with me, Adriel Lewis, Ruby, and Gina. We are here and about to wrap it up. But before we do so, I'd like to, you know, open up the community calendar. And speaking about the whole issue of, you know, kind of global solidarity and really, you know, cross-cultural exchange, I want to invite you guys to come out January 11th, our good friend Dun Dun from the Plena group Las Racas. If you guys are from the Bay, I'm sure you've heard of them. They're doing a little benefit show over at La Peña Cultural Center. Once again, January 11th at 8 p.m. Our friend Dun Dun, he's been working to get his citizenship for a while now. So this is going to be a fundraiser to kind of help towards that effort. Also, if you guys are more towards the South Bay, I'd like to invite you on January 26th to the Asian American Students Association. Every year they have a conference called Listen to the Silence. It's an Asian American Issues Conference. And this is going to be the 12th one. So if you guys want to come by, you know, check out their website at aasa.stanford.edu. Me and my group and with Ruby Illiteracy will be performing, as well as Kiwi, who, you know, has also been a vital part of Apex Express, and also some other really dope performers. And so definitely come through and check that out. And I'm going to pass it on to Gina.
Hey, if you want to contact Apex Express, you can do so. We got a couple of ways to do so. You can call us by going to 510-848-6767, extension 464. That's 510-848-6767, extension 464. Or you can go to apex@kpfa.org. And for more information, written pieces rather, some audio clips that haven't been aired here, you can go to our website, which is www.apexexpress.org. That's APEXEXPRESS.ORG. Asian Pacific Islander news, music, sounds, which you've never heard before in the nation, perhaps. Definitely in the Northern Bay Area, the northern part of California, right here on KPFA and KPFB in Berkeley, KFCF, and in Fresno, and www.kpfa.org, where you can hear past programs if you go on to that website. Also, we have a music education program. There's so many music lacking programs. I mean, the school system has completely decimated the arts education. But in other countries, it's even worse. But there is an organization that's what they're dedicated to. They're dedicated to buying musical instruments, dedicated to having teachers, paying for the teachers to come and teach kids in poverty, kids with disability, kids who are really in need of help, not only in the United States, like in Oakland, but also places like Brazil, places like India, and other parts of the world. And this organization is called Ahimsa. And they're still looking for donations starting from the holiday season. And they would appreciate any support or donations that you can give. And you can go on their website. They have a wonderful website where they show all the different 5, 6, 7, 8 different projects that they're involved with. But music education is really unique, and it's really a way to give people hope. And it's really incredible. So that website is www.projectahimsa.org/holiday. Let me spell that for you. PROJECTAHIMSA.ORG. And again, music education is a gift that cannot be taken away. Also wanted to say that the Asian Art Museum has a lot of programs, not just the exhibits, but they have incredible exhibits for kids, for adults. Also, to ring in the new year, January 5th, Mochizuki, Mochi Pounding. And in Japan, you get this big wooden hammers, you get soft rice, boiled rice, and you beat the heck out of it, and then you choke on it when you heat it if you don't eat it, chew it enough. But I'm just kidding. But yes, every year somebody just gulps.
Sounds
that.
Sounds delicious.
You know, sticky rice is such a thing in Asia but if you don't chew it well, believe me, it'll give you a lot of trouble. Anyways, mochi pounding at the Asian Art Museum, January 5th. 12 o'clock to 1, and we're going to have the Kagamikai, which is the organization, the group that comes in. They put on performance pounding rice, including music and dance, costumes. So, yeah, you guys can come in and use your muscle there to pound mochi rice.
Just my good one muscle.
Too much talking, yeah. You see, that's not, you know, the New Year's resolution, Angel. You got to, you know, and Ruby, too. You guys got New Year's resolutions?
You know, like, so for the last few years, I've been doing the whole, I'm not going to do a resolution. I'm just going to change my life day by day.
Yeah,
thing. But now everybody's doing that. And so I feel like,
isn't that your one-step program?
You know, something like that. But, you know, it's like, who's really good at keeping resolutions? So I just decided I feel like I've been doing all right, you know? So I didn't even make any resolutions. But, you know, dealing with the whole chewing sticky rice thing, I think that's really important. There's this, this Chinese movie that I was watching, and this guy was in prison for a really long time, and then he finally got released, and then he ate a bunch of sticky rice and drank tea, and then he died because all the rice expanded inside of his stomach, and his stomach wasn't used to it.
Oh, gross. Oh, yeah. That for real?
Yeah. Anyway,
okay, what a wonderful way to start off our first show.
Yeah, it ended, you know, just I wanted to end it on a high note, you know? On some cultural exchange. Yeah, that's the struggle us Asians deal with. We have to chew our sticky rice, unlike you and your rice cakes.
Rice cakes.
What is sticky rice? Maybe you can explain it, Ruby, what's sticky rice. I don't think people really know.
You know, I'm not even sure if I know. I mean, my version of sticky rice, I'm Filipino, so we have, like, what's called bibingka, and it's more of a dessert, and it's, like, a really heavy kind of, like, you know, really sticky and sweet and, you know, rich kind of rice, but
that's sticky rice.
So I don't know if other people make it differently, but I definitely have to chew my bibingka.
You put different things in it, sugar, whatever. But anyways, that's a big New Year's food too in a lot of Asian cultures. I just want to say we are going to go out with some music. Maybe Angel.
Yes, this is Tigara. It is Color, Culture, Money, and Beauty. Did I say it right? Tigara.
I'm pretty sure it's Tigara.
It's Tigara, not Tigara. I said it like I was from like deep Oklahoma. It's Tigara. Color, culture, money, and beauty. I like this music. It's great, like spaz out music. And, you know,
She's got an interesting background. She's actually Japanese, but she went to Brazil. That's where she got a lot of her musical influence. She actually has a background in business or economics, and she thought that music is a way to capture more interest among younger Japanese. But the thing is, a lot of Japanese are actually living in Brazil. There's a lot of Japanese who left Japan, went to the United States, but even more went to Brazil. So she went over to Brazil. I think she hooked up with some Japanese there who lived there, went back to Japan, and, you know, that whole influence in their stories in her music, too. So we're going to check this music out, and then we're going to say goodbye for the show and see you next Thursday.
Yes.
We're going to go out with some music. Hold on.
Peace. You can look forward to more funerals, more cubicles.
The one, two after this one. No, it's the one before that one. I'm sorry.
We are still going here. We're going to go on to this music. Hold on one second. Yeah. Hold on.
We just wanted to, you know, make it suspenseful.
Okay. Hold on.
Yeah. That was for that. This isn't it either. Don't worry. It's going to be real spazz out music. I promise.
Is it track 4?
You know, it's track, it's track 5.
Track 5.
Track 5.
Okay, folks. Hold on.
It's going to happen. Watch.
Good night, y'all.
Good night.
する。お金があれば駒になるもの。何の子供がわずかな命、主必死に。
それでもあなたと考えるならいくらでも繰り返すけど。
Just returned from a fact-gathering mission in Iran, former UN weapons inspector Scott Ritter and his delegation will lead the Iran talks, a series of public forums on U.S. foreign policy. Ritter and Jeff Cohen, the founder of Fairness and Accuracy in Reporting, will speak at the Mount Diablo Unitarian Universalist Church, 55 Eckley Lane in Walnut Creek, on Tuesday evening, January 15th at 7:30 p.m. Wheelchair accessible. For full information, please check the KPFA website or phone 925-933-7850. Again, 925-933-7850.